25 riders line up. It's the opening round of the MotoGP World Championship. 22 laps of the LaSalle International Circuit here in Qatar. 5 minutes to go. BMW safety car leaves the grid, races down towards turn one. Here we are. Here is the class 2015 for MotoGP. Loris Baz, Alex De Angelis, Eugene Lafferty, Carol Abraham, Mike DiMeglio, Jack Miller up from Moto3, Hector Barbera, Stefan Bradl, Nicky Hayden, world champion 10 years ago, Danilo Petrucci, Marco Melandri, former 250cc world champion, Yonny Hernandez, Scott Redding, Bradley Smith, Maverick Vinales, Alvaro Bautista, former 125cc world champion, Cal Crutchlow, Paul Espargaro, former Moto2 world champion, Andre Iannone, Aleix Espargaro, the man of the moment, Andrea Dovizioso. Danny Pedrosa has never won here in any class. Jorge Lorenzo, so successful at this circuit. Valentino Rossi, his 20th year of Grand Prix racing. But can anybody challenge the 22-year-old Spaniard, the double world champion, Marc Márquez? Strongest grid in MotoGP history. And here is the grid. We start with Dovizioso in pole.
Andrea Dovizioso, third pole position of his MotoGP career, ahead of Danny Pedrosa and Marc Márquez on the front row. Andrea Iannone also on the second row in fourth.
Here we are, Bradley Smith, Valentino Rossi, Danilo Petrucci, row three, row four. Paul Espargaro, his brother Aleix Espargaro, and Cal Crutchlow, despite that crash in qualifying.
Rookie Maverick Vinales in 13th, Scott Redding 14th, Hector Barbera on row five. DiMeglio Hayden and Stefan Bradl, the German, completes row six.
Row seven, Eugene Lafferty on his debut, Carol Abraham and Alvaro Bautista. Row eight, Jack Miller, Loris Baz and Alex De Angelis.
And on his own on row 9, number 33, Marco Melandri back in MotoGP for the first time since 2010.
The final sighting lap before the new season gets underway. There is the front row of the grid. There is the tyre choice.
Confirmation there of the tyre choices. Andrea Dovizioso, Danny Pedrosa and Marc Márquez all opting for that medium compound front slick. They're all on the medium rear. So they're all on the same tyres. All the guys in the front row of the grid have gone for the same tyre options. Dovizioso just about to pull away on this warm-up lap. We're moments away from the start of the 2015 MotoGP World Championship.
The riders stream away down towards turn one. Good evening to you. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me, Matt Burt. Down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. How is it down there, Dylan?
Oh, absolutely perfect conditions. There's so much excitement here. It's really, really buzzing. People just want to get going. And it's a good, you know, absolutely fantastic conditions to go racing. One thing that is going to be really interesting, we saw the tyre graphic, medium front, medium rear. But have a look behind. The likes of Valentino Rossi, Bradley Smith, they are opting with the harder option front. So are some of the other guys. So depending on whether the temperature drops during the race, that could have a bit of an effect.
Always a bit of intrigue, isn't there, over tyre choice in MotoGP. And once again, that is going to prove that is going to be a big, big talking point. There is Lorenzo. Remember, he crashed out on the very first lap last year. Márquez going through. Stefan Bradl could have won the race last year, making his Yamaha debut. There's so many stories to relate here. But the big story so far is all about Ducati and Andrea Dovizioso. We're in Qatar. It's the opening round of the MotoGP World Championship under the floodlights. Good evening, I'm Nick Harris. Alongside me is Matt Bird, and down in pit lane, it is Dylan Gray. What a race this is going to be. We have a Ducati with Andrea Dovizioso in pole position. Can Marc Marquez fight off the challenge of the Ducati? What is Danny Pedrosa going to do alongside him on the front row of the grid? And how are the Yamahas going to fare? You can answer all that in one go, Matt. You're a better man than I am.
Well, we'll find out, Nick, over the next 45 minutes or so. The riders come to the grid for the first race of the 2015 MotoGP World Championship.
They line up. This is the moment we have been waiting for since November. This is the moment Ducati have been waiting for 5 long years. 22 laps of the LaSalle International Circuit. Round one of the 18-round 2015 MotoGP World Championship. Dovizioso, Pedrosa and Marquez. We are underway, 2015.
Dovizioso got away well, so did Danny Pedrosa from the centre of the front row. It's a great start by number four, Andrea Dovizioso. He's going to lead the field into the first corner with Bradley Smith coming up beside the top three.
Yeah, great start by Bradley Smith. And somebody having to sit
Marc
up
Marquez,
there.
Marc Marquez is at the back of the field, Nick. He ran off at the first corner.
Marquez in big trouble. Dovizioso and the Ducati lead the way. Well, Marc Marquez had to really sit up going into turn one. Jorge Lorenzo in second place.
Well, it was drama on the opening lap of the season in 2014 for Jorge Lorenzo. This time around, it's Marc Marquez, the world champion, at the back of the field. A runoff at the first corner. We'll await a replay to see exactly what happened. There is Marquez now, siding his way through the field. He picks up Alvaro Bautista at turn six. Marquez on a mission, but he's got to be. He's way down the field.
Oh, what an opening for Marc Marquez. What an opening for Andrea Dovizioso. He has put the Ducati at the front. What a start by Jorge Lorenzo from the second row of the grid.
Bad start for Valentino Rossi. Rossi dropped a couple of places back down to 10th. As you say, Nick, Lorenzo got a great start from 6th. He's putting the pressure on Andrea Dovizioso. It's Ian Oni in third.
So, super stuff for Ducati. Great start from Bradley Smith, as you say. Much, much better for Yamaha than we thought it was going to be with Jorge Lorenzo. Lorenzo now tailing Dovizioso. Will he let him run at the front? What about Iannone? He's not a man that likes to hang around in third place. Just the start we wanted, apart from Marc Marquez. Lorenzo thinks about it, first time in to turn 16. Iannone right behind him. Look at the grunt of the Ducatis now against the Yamahas.
Dovizioso coming down the start-finish straight to complete a dramatic first lap. Dovizioso, Ducati, Lorenzo Yamaha, Ian Oni Ducati, Yoni Hernandez in fourth with Bradley Smith and Paul Espargaro in sixth place.
Lorenzo did an excellent job there to hang onto that rear wheel of Andrea Dovizioso, and Iannone wasn't able to come through. They come through turn two, up now towards turn three. Ducati versus Yamaha. Crossing the line, Marc Marquez. Yes, Marc Marquez was down in 17th place, and it looks like a retirement or into the pits for Alvaro Bautista on the Aprilia.
What a disastrous start to the season for Repsol Honda. Marc Marquez ran off at the first corner, dropped right to the back of the field, and Danny Pedrosa, who looked like he got a pretty clean getaway from second on the grid, Pedrosa has dropped back to ninth. He's trying to make his way by Danilo Petrucci as Dovizioso coming under more pressure from Jorge Lorenzo on lap two.
What a funny old game this is. There was Yamaha and all those big problems. And we've got Paul Espargaro, Bradley Smith, and we've got Jorge Lorenzo right in there, meeting head-on the Ducatis. And the two Hondas in big, big trouble.
Lorenzo swarming all over the back wheel of Andrea Dovizioso's new Ducati GP15. Lorenzo's going to attack, going into turn 12. Lorenzo makes the pass stick. Classic Jorge Lorenzo move. He takes the lead on lap two.
Jorge Lorenzo, remember, crashed out in the race last year on the first lap. He has got a great record here. We ride with him, right in his face, the number four, the GP15 Ducati of Andrea Dovizioso. Welcome back, MotoGP. We've missed you so, so much.
We ride on board with Marc Márquez, the world champion, climbed back up to 14th. He's just passed Scott Redding going into this final corner to complete turn two. But Márquez is 3.9 seconds back of the race leader who's just crossed the line, Jorge Lorenzo.
Lorenzo leads the way, the two Ducatis behind him, then just a little bit of a gap. Yoni Hernandez coming under pressure from Bradley Smith. Well, the two Tech 3 Yamahas of Bradley Smith and Paul Espargaro, there they are.
That looked like Jack Miller running off the Australian rookie at the first corner. Miller was in 16th place, but it did look like he was running off the track at the first corner, as it's still Jorge Lorenzo, the two factory Ducatis behind him. Dovizioso from Iannone. Rossi and Pedrosa finally starting to make some inroads towards the top six. They've both passed Danilo Petrucci. Pedrosa seventh, Rossi eighth.
We ride with Andrea Dovizioso. Put that GP15 Ducati in pole position for the first time. There are the two Ducatis. Then there's a little bit of a gap. Then it is another Ducati, Yoni Hernandez. But he is being pushed very hard now by the two Tech 3 Yamaha riders, Bradley Smith and Paul Espargaro. Can Márquez from that position challenge at the front? It's a big ask with the lap times they're putting in. But if anybody can do it, he can.
If anybody can do it, it can be Márquez, but you have to think, even for a rider of his mercurial talent, it's a bridge too far. Márquez has recovered back to 12th. He's 4.2 seconds behind Jorge Lorenzo, who just set the fastest lap of the race on lap two, a 1:55.428. We ride on board again with Márquez. Well, here we go, this is what happened to him. Well, he almost ran into the back of Bradley Smith, didn't he? That was what happened to Marc Márquez. He got in too hot into that first corner, and here he is picking up Alvaro Bautista through turn six.
Fast his way through, Alvaro Bautista is now in the pits with the Aprilia. Just wonder if that was the corner. Back at the front of the race, Lorenzo still leads the way. Those two red Ducatis from Bologna and Italy harrying and harassing him. They have that little bit extra pace, but Lorenzo, top class into turn one.
There's clear daylight now between Lorenzo, your leader, Dovizioso and Iannone. Yoni Hernandez still holding a fantastic fourth position, but the rest of the field, they're 2 seconds behind the podium chase.
Yeah, Danny Pedrosa and Valentino Rossi now moving forward, as you say. They have Yoni Hernandez in their sights.
Oh, Iannone thought about a look up the inside of his teammate, Andrea Dovizioso, at turn four, thought better of it. But Pedrosa, Rossi, Smith, they've got to get power by Yoni Hernandez as quickly as possible. Otherwise, his top three, they'll be long gone into the desert night.
What a disaster that could have been for Andrea Iannone. Thought about it, didn't he? But then decided, no, let's just wait and see where we are.
I think he'd have been walking to Austin if he'd have taken him out there, wouldn't you?
I think he probably would have been. But Lorenzo, after his disasters last year, showing the sort of form that brought him those two world titles. Here is Valentino Rossi, an unusual in the last year, certainly bad start by the 9-time world champion.
Rossi has fought his way by Danny Pedrosa on lap four. Pedrosa, though, immediately fights back. Rossi up the inside again. This is like Rossi Márquez. Instead, it's Rossi versus Pedrosa as they still try and find a way by Yoni Hernandez, who's doing a great job, as we said, in holding both of them at bay to keep that fourth spot.
You're so right what you said, though. Rossi just knows he's got to get through, and he's got to go through very, very quickly with him. We ride with Valentino Rossi. Danny Pedrosa made come up the inside. He's got up the inside of Yoni Hernandez, and has he got through? Yes, he has. Rossi now moves up into fourth place. Danny Pedrosa, you would imagine, would come through, but Hernandez and that Ducati are quick as they dip it into turn one.
How quick they are. Hernandez briefly took fourth place back from Rossi, but Rossi, we know, a demon on the brakes into the first corner, and he quickly disposes of the Colombian. Danny Pedrosa, though, can't respond. Chance for perhaps Rossi to make a break in fourth as he tries to chase down his teammate Jorge Lorenzo, Dovizioso and Iannone, still your top three.
There are the leading trio. Then this battle for fourth place. Rossi, Pedrosa just gets through. just it is. Kyle Crutchlow now being able to make a move, and it looks like a mistake from Paul Espargaro running it wide.
It was indeed that Kyle Crutchlow comes through. Marc Márquez on the charge. He dives up the inside of Kyle Crutchlow at turn six, the slowest corner on the track. Márquez has already picked up Bautista there on the first lap. He does the same to Kyle Crutchlow. Marc Márquez up to ninth place.
He was last, wasn't he? Was he very last? Absolutely last. An amazing performance already by Marc Márquez. Is the pace too fast at the front? We're really not sure. It's Danny Pedrosa. Johnny Hernandez now coming under a little bit of pressure from Bradley Smith, who's actually done really well to hang in there with those factory riders.
This is the battle for the lead. 18 laps to go. Jorge Lorenzo, Dovizioso and Iannone making no impression as yet. Rossi trying to claw that gap back. Rossi, 2.3 seconds. He is behind his factory Yamaha teammate. Márquez, the man to watch, though, as he scythes his way through the field towards this podium battle.
We're into the unknown with Ducati now, aren't we? For them, for the machine, for Dovizioso, they just don't know. Will the tyres go off? Will something happen, or will it run at the same rate? We don't know. There are 17 laps to go. Lorenzo still leads the way. And a little bit of a gap just opening up between Dovizioso and Iannone. And Rossi really is on the charge in fourth place, as, of course, is Márquez. Márquez is coming, and he's coming mighty fast.
And so is Valentino Rossi. As you just said, Nick, he's on the charge. Fastest lap of the race from the 36-year-old Italian, a 1:55.267. That gap to Iannone now down to 1.5 seconds. Rossi was almost 0.8 seconds quicker on lap five than Iannone. The charge from the veteran is on.
They could be there, Rossi and Márquez, couldn't they? At this sort of rate, they could be there. It's three at the moment, it could be five. Lorenzo doing all the donkey work at the front. Got to say, Dovizioso looks very, very comfortable in second place.
Guys, just a quick word from pit lane. Bautista came in. The words he was saying when he got off his bike were Márquez, Márquez. So it seems like there was some kind of touch, some kind of issue with the bike after that contact.
There was certainly a contact. Márquez just sliced through, obviously furious at what happened. Now Márquez chasing after Bradley Smith. Smith running seventh, Márquez running in eighth place.
We ride on board with Andrea Dovizioso in second place. Third gear, 185 kilometers an hour through this turn 13, now into 14, remaining in third, chasing Lorenzo. Great rider comparison between the two of them as they come through the penultimate corner. This is where Lorenzo perished last year. He's taking the lead, though, in this race. He's led from the second lap as they come down to complete lap six.
Right, into 16, listening to go up through the gearbox. What is that top speed going to be? At the top is Dovizioso, below him is the Yamaha of Lorenzo. You would imagine topping out will be the Ducati 356 kilometers an hour. Down into second for turn one. So, the battle is on. We have Lorenzo, we have the two Ducatis. Don't rule out Rossi and don't rule out Márquez.
Valentino Rossi quicker again on lap six. Half a second he just made up on Iannone. Valentino Rossi chasing a 10th world title. As we say, up into fourth place. Marc Márquez now in seventh as we ride back on board with Jorge Lorenzo. Andrea Dovizioso, his teammate Andrea Iannone, closely behind. But it's Lorenzo still leading by just over a 10th of a second. We're on lap seven.
Yeah, look out for Rossi, look out for Márquez. Is the pace at the front fast enough? Can they catch this leading trio? Lorenzo had not looked happy in practice. Slight improvement in qualifying, but this is the Lorenzo we know, isn't it? Riding a great race. He is such a capable rider at the front as well. Mr. Smooth.
Right, guys, latest on Bautista, thanks to my Spanish colleagues here in pit lane as well, is basically one of the connectors to the front caliper on his left-hand side was broken, so he was actually only left with one front caliper breaking. That's why he had to come back in.
Yeah, I wonder, don't let's spoil the battle. I think it will be looked at by video, don't you, what happened? But we're not going to surmise. Rossi is closing dramatically now on that leading duo. And here is Marquez trying now to get past Yoni and Anderson. As always happens in these situations, the higher you get up, it gets more and more difficult to get past people. And the pace at the front is so fast. The progress you make early on is not the same. This is the Ducati of Yoni Hernandez as we ride with Marquez. And Marquez has not got the grunt to get past him on that long start and finish straight.
I was just going to say, Nick, perfect evidence there of how quick that Ducati is in the straight line. Marquez did not get a sniff down the start and finish straight of passing Yoni Hernandez through the first corner. But it's again Valentino Rossi of the top four who is the fastest. The gap now between Lorenzo and Rossi, 1.4 seconds.
And he has got through. Marquez now, as we would expect, has gone through on Yoni Hernandez. And Yoni Hernandez says, you may be the double world champion. You may have just passed me, but it ain't going to be that easy. And typically, Marquez is right back in his face and retakes the advantage.
Marquez took Hernandez at turn four. Hernandez hit back at five. And then Marquez, as he finally made it stick on the Colombian at turn six, that puts him now behind his factory Honda teammate, Dani Pedrosa. Marquez up to six. Who would have thought that just a few moments ago when he was running through the runoff gravel trap at the first corner when he was so close to tagging the back of Bradley Smith.
So Lorenzo still leads away. This is the helicopter shot, then the two Ducatis. And Valentino Rossi, you can see at the back there, is closing on them all the time. Yamaha, Ducati, Ducati, Yamaha. Where are the Hondas? They are on the charge. They're really on the charge with Marc Marquez. And don't rule out Dani Pedrosa either. Lorenzo has led from the very early stages. Dovizioso and Iannone look comfortable. Rossi has to work mighty, mighty hard to get up there with them. But he is closing all the time. 14 and a half laps to go.
Lorenzo, Dovizioso, Iannone, Rossi, that's your leading four. Is Dovizioso going to pull out of the slipstream and attack Lorenzo? He is. Dovizioso's got the inside line. He's taken the lead from Lorenzo at the first corner on lap nine. Dovizioso, the pole man, back in the lead.
I wonder if he's been told that Rossi is on the charge and decided time to up the pace a little bit. We don't want Rossi joining in this particular fight. Lorenzo will be quite happy to hang in there, as is Iannone. Can Rossi charge now, or can Dovizioso really open up a bit of an advantage and try and prevent Rossi from joining the trio?
And bear in mind, in that group of four, the only tyre differential is that Rossi has that harder option front, so you know, the longer this fight goes on, Rossi may get stronger and stronger.
Oh, just what we need.
Well, all throughout practice, Dovizioso knows he's had the measure on outright pace of Jorge Lorenzo as Loris Baz, unfortunately, the French rookie. Disappointing start to his MotoGP career. He's just explaining some issues to his Ford racing mechanics. Lorenzo, just a big moment on the rear as they come through turn nine. Here is Dovizioso leading. Lorenzo in second. Iannone, he's been in third for a long time. The Italian just set a personal best lap of the race. He's got to get a shift on because he knows his compatriot Valentino Rossi is right behind and wanting to take that final place on the podium off him. Rossi right there now on the back of this top three.
What a remarkable ride by the 36-year-old. What a remarkable ride by the man coming into his 20th season in Grand Prix motorcycle racing.
Well, he's done it again, hasn't he, Nick? He dropped back to 10th place on the first lap. That's where he came from last year to fight Marc Marquez all the way for the victory. And Rossi now is right in contention for his 83rd Premier Class win. Dovizioso trying to take his second. He crosses the line to lead from Lorenzo, Iannone and Rossi.
We ride with Rossi. That is Iannone and Lorenzo in front of him. And you just get a glimpse there of Dovizioso who leads the race. This is coming into turn one. Is Lorenzo having a few tyre problems? He just seems a couple of times to run it just a little bit wide to me.
Yeah, he's just dropped into the 156 bracket as well, Jorge Lorenzo. Dovizioso, Iannone, Rossi, they're all still in the 155s. And Dovizioso is trying to make a break
here. He is, and you get the feeling that Iannone is lining up Lorenzo as quick as he can because he knows, he can hear that Rossi is right behind him.
So just a quick word, guys, on tyre problems. That's the issue why Loris Baz has come in. The team's not quite sure, but they are now going to try and pop in some different tyres and send him back out on the same bike, at least for experience purposes.
Still Pedrosa fifth, Marc Marquez sixth, Yoni Hernandez seventh, Bradley Smith eighth, Cal Crutchlow nine, Paul Espargaró 10, Aleix Espargaró 11, Scott Redding 12, Petrucci 13, Nicky Hayden 14, and Stefan Bradl in 15th place.
Dovizioso leads the Qatar Grand Prix. Jorge Lorenzo hanging on there in second place as they go through this fifth gear, turn 11. Ian Only in third, Rossi at the back of that group. Danny Pedrosa in fifth, 4 seconds back. Marc Marquez in sixth, a further 1.1 seconds behind his HRC teammate. Marquez, 5.5 seconds he is off Dovizioso, who's leading this race. Is that too much for the Spaniard to fight back? You can never rule him out.
You can't, but I think it is. I think it is, because these four at the front are setting a fair old place. What do I know about Jorge Lorenzo? Because he's retaken the lead at the front. He's got past Dovizioso, so Yamaha back at the front. Ducati, Ducati, and then Yamaha once again. He's sizing it all up. He's looking at all the options, Jorge Lorenzo. The two Ducatis power past him. Iannone's got through on him as well. So Dovizioso leaves Iannone, but he leaves a bit of a gap. Lorenzo goes back through.
Great move by Lorenzo at the first corner to take second place straight back from Andrea Iannone. Lorenzo led onto the start, finished straight to complete lap 10, but Ducati power blitzed by him.
Up towards turns 4 and 5, we ride with Lorenzo. That is Dovizioso tipping it into turn 4. We have 11 and a half laps to go. We waited a long time for this race, and the wait is worth every single minute.
Well, we thought it was going to be Ducati versus Honda. It's Ducati versus Yamaha at the moment. 12 laps to go. Dovizioso out in front. Started from pole position. Jorge Lorenzo led the way for a while. As we look at Dovizioso now, second gear as he comes on to the start, finish straight. Sorry, he's going through turn 11. Now, that was turn 10. Just getting a bit confused with the floodlights there. But Dovizioso still leading this race. Can he take the GP15 to a debut victory here? Lorenzo, though, is putting the pressure back on the Italian.
He really is piling on the pressure. We know that Ducati's a bit quicker, but into the very faster right-hander. And it's Jorge Lorenzo that has taken the lead. Lorenzo leads away from Dovizioso. Iannone coming under real, real pressure from his great mate, Valentino Rossi. This is great to see Lorenzo ride like this. This is the Lorenzo that won those two world titles. And here comes Rossi off the inside of Iannone. Valentino Rossi into third place.
Valentino Rossi takes third place, but Ian on his fourth back. Rossi up the inside again at turn 16. Dramatic stuff here from the Italians. Lorenzo's going to lead over the line to start lap 11. Dovizioso, can he get the slipstream again down to the first corner? Look at that Ducati power. Rossi came onto the straight in third, but Iannone shoots by to retake third place. Lorenzo, though, into the first corner as Marquez now right on the back wheel of his teammate Danny Pedrosa.
Yeah, you'd have thought this would have been a battle for the lead or the podium. It's not, it's a battle for fifth place. Here is the Suzuki of Aleix Espargaró running in 11th place. That is his brother, Paul Espargaró, just in front of him. Smith involved in a battle with Cal Crutchlow. All British battle. A lot of pride at stake in that particular one. This is amazing to see the two Hondas so far down, isn't it?
Marc Marquez has made it by his teammate Danny Pedrosa, lap 12. Marquez through at turn 5. Here we go through the slowest corner on the track, turn 6. But Marquez now from the back of the grid after running off at the first corner of the race has finally made a move on his teammate. Marquez 4.3 seconds back of Jorge Lorenzo.
Oh, Marquez comes up on the board for the lads in front, but he's a fair bit back. I can't believe he's going to make up that advantage. There you go. It's around 3.7 seconds between Valentino Rossi and Marc Marquez. It's still Jorge Lorenzo that leads the way. Dovizioso, Rossi in front of Iannone. One of the tactics here, because coming out of turn 16, there is no doubt that the Ducati has more grunt, doesn't it?
This is Lorenzo at the end of 2013, isn't it, Nick, when he was so dominant. 5 wins in the last 7 races. Lorenzo now coming to finish lap 12 in the lead.
Here is Rossi fighting hard with Dovizioso. They're absolutely slopped side by side. Dovizioso holds the advantage. Lorenzo still leads the way to open up a bit of a gap.
Rossi thought he made a move on Dovizioso there to take second place and begin the pursuit of his teammate Jorge Lorenzo, but Dovizioso fought back. Lorenzo, Dovizioso, Rossi, Ian Only through down to turn two on lap 13. The Hondas trying to claw back the deficit. Marquez fifth, Pedrosa sixth. Hernandez still doing a great job to hang on to seventh place as Rossi again having another look at Dovizioso.
He's trying all he can to get past Andrea Dovizioso. He wants to get the Yamahas first and second. Lorenzo still leads the way. Iannone, well, right in there. It's going to be between these four shortly. I really don't think that Marc Marquez can close that sort of advantage. It's a difficult one to call, this is. As I say, the Ducatis, the factory, the GP15s are into unknown territory. They really don't know. But I would think they're pretty encouraged what they've seen and felt so far.
Absolutely, Dovizioso in second place. This was at the stage of the races last year when we saw the GP14 slip down the field. They could always run the pace for the first few laps, but with that understeer issue, it meant that Dovizioso and Ian Only, they had to override that bike. It was a really physically demanding bike, and they would always just drop back down the field. But Dovizioso and Ian Only, they've kept themselves in podium contention right from the start, as we expected.
Look at that graphic. There is Dovizioso at the top, and he's the man in picture because we ride with Valentino Rossi. Throttle and brake pretty much together, as you would expect, although they are on different machines. Dovizioso on the Ducati, Rossi on the Yamaha. You just got a glimpse there of the race leader, Jorge Lorenzo. When they cross the line, there will be nine laps to go. They come onto the long start and finish straight, around 215 miles an hour down here.
Lorenzo leading the way, Dovizioso still in second place, but it's Dovizioso making a move. We ride on board with Rossi. Dovizioso has taken the lead on the brakes into turn one. Great shot of that on board with Valentino Rossi as we saw Dovizioso move effortlessly by Jorge Lorenzo to take the lead. Desmo Dobby back in the lead. Rossi now in third by Andrea Iannone. The chase is on.
It's almost as if Dovizioso is saying, if I'm this close and we come into that last corner, the Ducati is going to outrun you to the line. So you've got two of the most experienced and best Grand Prix racers ever in Jorge Lorenzo and Valentino Rossi. What can they do about that? And don't rule out Andrea Iannone. He's kept his powder very, very dry.
He has indeed, Nick. Despite those top four having a real good battle for the lead, they're still lapping faster than Marc Marquez. Marc Marquez making no initial inroads now into that podium battle. 4.8 seconds he is behind the leader, Jorge Lorenzo, as we ride with Cal Crutchlow, the British rider inside the top nine. He'll be behind his compatriot, Bradley Smith.
This is going to be a good battle, I think, for seventh place. You've got a glimpse there of Yonny Hernandez in front of them. There you go. This is for seventh place. Smith made an electric start. You're almost involved in the incident with Marc Marquez in the turn one that pushed the world champion right back to last place. We're praising so many people, but this is a fantastic ride again by Hernandez.
Looking at, here we go, Jorge Lorenzo. Just going to say, looking at the split times through T3, Jorge Lorenzo has taken the lead back from Andrea Dovizioso through turn 16, the final corner. Onto the start, finish straight to finish lap 14. Lorenzo back in the lead. Last time round, we saw Valentino Rossi on board footage. Great shot of Dovizioso taking the lead. Dovizioso's coming back again at the first corner.
Yeah, and it's the power of the Ducati that must worry the Yamahas. Look at Lorenzo. Mr. Smooth back up the inside at turn one.
Dovizioso just got in too hot into the first corner, left the door open for Jorge Lorenzo. He needed no second invitation. Lorenzo back in the lead. The Spaniard chasing a 34th MotoGP win. The two Repsol Hondas there just at the back of the shot. Marquez has lost another 2/1 of a second. As we say, he's not really making any progress to try and join this quartet fighting for the win.
7.5 laps to go. What an opener to the 2015 MotoGP season. Lorenzo leads the way to Dovizioso, Rossi and Iannone. And that is the gap between Iannone and Marquez. And Marc Marquez, at least he's going to pick up some points and some decent points. There he went to last place after problems on the very first bend. the very first defence of his title. Who's going to come out on top in this one? I'm not sure, but if I had to put money on it, I'm going to put it on Dovizioso.
Lorenzo looking strong. Anybody's guess? It's Yamaha Ducati. Yamaha Ducati. Fantastic four-way fight for the victory. Lorenzo, 4 thousandths of a second at the moment, clear of Dovizioso. Marc Márquez is steadily pulling away from Dani Pedrosa in fifth. Pedrosa almost half a second back of his teammate now. Are we going to see 8 laps to go? A late charge from Marc Márquez. Can he get himself back into contention? It's a big ask.
Lorenzo leads away. When they cross the line, there will be 7 laps to go of this LaSalle International Circuit. Here comes the Ducati. Here is Marc Márquez. He is cutting the gap down. I just don't think time is on his side. But a great ride by Márquez as he in turn tips it into turn one. But at the front, Lorenzo now under big, big pressure from Dovizioso. Rossi waiting to pounce. Giannone has not made a move yet, but he's very capable of hanging in there with the three best MotoGP riders, perhaps with the exception of Marc Márquez, in the world.
Yeah, Ian O'Neill showing no signs of being dropped off this leading bunch at all as we ride with Jorge Lorenzo. Great onboard shot, Dovizioso, as we come into this slow turn six. Dovizioso second, Rossi and Ian O'Neill right behind him.
Switch. Rossi desperate to get past Dovizioso. He's going to have a nibble now, Valentino Rossi. He's lining up. Is he close enough? Here we go. This is Lorenzo. We ride with Dovizioso. Be aware there may be another Yamaha coming into view any moment now. Up the inside or round the outside. Second gear for Lorenzo. Third gear. Fourth gear. Fifth. And then into this succession of three right-handers. Third gear, they're quick right-handers, these.
Well, as Dylan pointed out earlier on in the commentary, Valentino Rossi, the only one of this top four that's got the hard option front tyre on. Is that going to be a crucial decision as we enter these final 7 laps? Because we're at the stage of the race now where that tyre should really be coming into its own.
Into turn 16. There will be 6 laps to go when they cross the line. It is a long run to the line, as you will see. We ride with the GP15 Ducati at pole setter, Andrea Dovizioso. The man in front of him is Jorge Lorenzo. Rossi can't quite get close enough. Dovizioso thought about it, but Lorenzo is absolutely magic into turn one.
Well, we said how Ian O'Neill was hanging on to the top four. He's lost a bit of ground as the Italian. 1.1 seconds, he is now off of Jorge Lorenzo. Marc Márquez in the top speed standings. 218 miles an hour from the Repsol Honda.
Kyle Crutchlow has moved up to the 7th place. Yonny Hernández 8th and Bradley Smith in 9th.
Yonny Hernández keeping some really good company there in that battle for 7th place. Factory bikes all around him, of course. Hernández having big moments now on the front as Bradley Smith tries to make the Colombian move, lose another place. He's got his teammate Hollis Espargaro for company. Smith now trying to make sure that Crutchlow doesn't make a breakaway in 7th.
Well, Yonny Hernández has been a very, very difficult man to overtake through this race. That's a great performance by Cal Crutchlow. Don't forget, he crashed out in qualifying and by crashing out had to start from 12th place, as you were at the front, Lorenzo Dovizioso. And they are, I think, just beginning to drop Yannone. Could he come under pressure, Yannone, from Márquez?
Rossi at turn 12. He had a good look up the inside of Dovizioso. Couldn't make the pass stick. Yannone does look like he's struggling to match the pace of this top three. Yannone now, what, a second away from Lorenzo, as Rossi now really trying to get through by on Dovizioso. Thought Dovizioso there was going to have a look up the inside of Jorge Lorenzo.
Yeah, Rossi's first real go at Dovizioso, it didn't work out. Just got a glimpse there of Márquez at the top of the picture, still running in 4th place. Rossi once again trying to line up Dovizioso, but he's not going to take him here. Dovizioso in turn may well take the lead, racing down towards turn one. 5 laps ago, an incredible opener to the season. Dovizioso does take the lead. Lorenzo second, Rossi third, Iannone in fourth place.
Another big mistake on the brakes, though, at turn one from Andrea Dovizioso. He took the lead on that long drag to the first corner from Jorge Lorenzo, but ran wide in turn one, and Lorenzo moves back into first place. Rossi couldn't capitalise. Rossi still in third.
Little puff of smoke there. I think it was Rossi that's back wheel just caught the edge of the track, but he's still in there in third place. Let's have a look here at Dovizioso. Yeah, he was in front, but yep, runs it wide. You don't need a second invitation for Rossi to go through. Certainly you don't for Lorenzo to go through. But Dovizioso has fought back. He's got past back in front of Valentino Rossi, but it's Lorenzo that still leads the way with 4.5 laps to go.
Andrea Iannone desperately trying to cling on to this battle for his first podium in MotoGP. Lorenzo, Dovizioso, Rossi. Rossi having a look, was he up the inside? No, they're so close now. Lorenzo, Dovizioso, Rossi. What a fight for the win here.
Rossi absolutely on the limit, trying to get through on Dovizioso. Bradley Smith now has got through on Yonny Hernández. All eyes, though, focus at the front of this incredible race. Lorenzo crashed out on the very first lap last year. Dovizioso in pole, giving that GP15 pole position to Ducati. And Valentino Rossi chasing his fourth MotoGP win as he starts his 20th Grand Prix season. His fourth MotoGP win at the LaSalle International Circuit. Into turn 16 they come. We ride with Valentino Rossi. That is Dovizioso and Lorenzo in front of him.
Dovizioso definitely close enough to use the slipstream to blitz past Jorge Lorenzo on the start-finish straight. Look, Dovizioso moves out and passes Lorenzo to take the lead. Is he going to make it stick this time? We've seen him run on a couple of times. He runs it a little bit wide, but no, he pulls it back. And now Dovizioso will have the line into turn two. Dovizioso in the lead, 4 laps to go. Gigi Deligna looks on, apprehensive, nervous. Is the bike that he created, what, only 35 days ago, Andrea Dovizioso? First rode that bike. It's leading the opening Grand Prix of the season. Rossi underneath Lorenzo at turn four. Rossi now on the charge. He doesn't want Lorenzo Dovizioso to get away. It's an all-Italian fight now at the front.
Rossi at last gets into second place. Most of the time he's been fighting against Dovizioso for second place, but now he's got past Lorenzo. And you're right, he does not want him to get away. We ride with Marc Márquez. The gap around 2.5 seconds between him and Iannone. He'd do well to pick up a fifth place after being knocked back to the very last place. Rossi is not letting the Ducati escape. Rossi ready to pounce. Second here last year, second here the year before. He wants to win the race. It's his 20th season of Grand Prix racing. He's right on the rear wheel of the Ducati that he used to ride. Not this one, but for the factory team. And Valentino Rossi leads the way.
Dovizioso, though, fights back straight away. Dovizioso retakes the lead. Rossi cuts it back, can't take it the inside line. Rossi and Dovizioso exchanging the lead on lap 19.
Down towards turn 15 they come. We are smiling here. We just cannot believe how good this race is.
Has that hard option front rear tyre choice though of Valentino Rossi going to prove to be an absolute masterstroke from the Italian? They come down the start finish straight to finish. 3 laps to go.
3 to go. The Ducati from pole position leads the way. Rossi probably will close up on the braking. Iannone has got past Lorenzo up into third place. So Rossi can have a double-pronged attack from Ducati. And it's Ducati that leads. Here is Márquez. He is flying now in the fifth place. And it does appear he's closing. Can he close enough? He's not going to get up with these men at the front. Just under 3 laps to go. They're up at turn 4. Ducati versus Yamaha. Italy versus Italy.
Lorenzo about to get a pit ball that Marc Márquez is closing with. Here's the battle at the front. Dovizioso and Valentino Rossi. The brand new GP15 Ducati leads the way from Valentino Rossi. As we said, chasing an 83rd MotoGP victory. What a way it would be for Rossi to start his bid for a 10th World Championship. Here we see Andrea Iannone taking third place off Jorge Lorenzo. Is Lorenzo's victory challenge over?
Dovizioso leads away. Rossi up the inside once again. Rossi retakes the lead. For how long? Not half a second. Dovizioso back in front. It was Rossi and Marquez this year. It's Rossi and Dovizioso this time, and he squeezes through.
Rossi through on Dovizioso at turn 12. Is Rossi trying to get to the front and make a little bit of a break? He knows that if he's behind Andrea Dovizioso coming out of the final corner on the last lap, he hasn't got the speed out of that Yamaha to slipstream by Dovizioso. Rossi needs three or four bike lengths coming out of the final corner on the last lap to fend off that more powerful Ducati. Dovizioso all over the back wheel of Rossi. Is Rossi going to kick off the 2015 MotoGP World Championship in style with a victory?
On the start and finish straight, look at the power of the Ducati. Eases his way past Valentino Rossi. Back in front, two laps ago. Rossi lines up the inside. Dovizioso runs it wide and Rossi's back in front.
Well, there you go, Nick. Rossi got a wake-up call that he knows that Dovizioso, if he's riding his slipstream on the last lap, Dovizioso has got the speed to out-drag him to the line. Rossi again up the inside. Brave move through turn four. Brilliant from the Italian. Two laps to go. Rossi from Dovizioso. This has been an epic battle, reminiscent of the fight last year between Rossi and Marquez. This time, it's Dovizioso.
Down at turn six, slowest bend on the circuit. Rossi holds the advantage, but Dovizioso, no, he has got that run out of turn 16. You know, and he's still fighting off Jorge Lorenzo. You just got a glimpse there of Marc Marquez. He's not going to catch them. Who's going to win this one? Rossi leads the way. Can he eke open a little bit of an advantage over Dovizioso? That's what he's got to try and do. He has got his head down. He starts his 20th season of Grand Prix racing. He's 36 years old. He's not riding with a pair of slippers there, I can assure you.
This is Valentino Rossi's 313th Grand Prix appearance, as fast, as hungry and motivated as ever. And he's eking away crucial bike lengths here from Andrea Dovizioso. Two laps to go. Rossi knows that he's got to be leading onto the start-finish straight by five or six bike lengths. The power of that Ducati will outgun him to the straight. Rossi has been a master tactician in the past. He knows exactly what he's got to do. Now let's see if Andrea Dovizioso drags him to the line. This is going to set up a dramatic finale. They come across the start-finish straight to start the final lap.
Now, is this a dress rehearsal? If Rossi has this advantage, can Dovizioso catch him? There's a very simple answer to that question. Yes, he can. So Rossi's got to try and open up some sort of advantage. We're into the last lap of an amazing opening round of the championship.
Rossi and Dovizioso going at it, hammer and tongs. Rossi runs it a little bit wide through turn two, pulls it back. Dovizioso, he's not giving up at all. Rossi still in the lead.
Up towards turn four, Rossi leads the way. The right-hander at the top end of the circuit. Dovizioso right behind him. He knows if he can stay this close, he could bring victory for the GP15 Ducati.
Coming up to the twisty sections of this LaSalle International Circuit. This is where the Yamaha normally works incredibly well. Rossi knows he's got to open up a gap. The anxious Ducati management look on. Claudio Domenicali, the Ducati boss, on the right.
Rossi still holds the advantage. Dovizioso, though, has him in his sights. This is where the Yamaha performs. Can he open up the advantage? The nine times world champion, 36 years old, fighting off the challenge of Dovizioso. One MotoGP victory to his credit.
Rossi 10th to second last year. Is he going to go one better in 2015? It's all going to come down to this last four or five corners. Rossi accelerates through turn 12. He's got a little bit of a gap now on Dovizioso. Dovizioso though comes back. It's going to go right down to the wire this first race.
They race down through the final one of the right-handers, down towards turn 15, the final left-hander. Is the gap big enough? Can Rossi just open up the advantage? Turn 16, the final bend approaches.
Here we go, Rossi now peeling into the right-hander through turn 16. Has he done enough? Valentino Rossi now powers that Yamaha to the straight. Dovizioso trying to get in the slipstream.
Here we go, the run to the line. Has Rossi done it? Here comes the Ducati. Valentino Rossi wins here in Qatar.
Valentino Rossi, an 83rd Premier Class victory, the 109th of his career. Andrea Dovizioso could not have done anything more, but Valentino Rossi, the old warhorse, there he was again. What a brilliant last lap. Dovizioso best lap of his race on the final lap, but it wasn't enough to deny Valentino Rossi. Rossi, Dovizioso, Iannone on the podium. What a race. Rossi, triumphant.
Wow, that's the only thing you can say. So, Marquez 5, Pedrosa 6, Crutchlow 7, Smith 8, Paul Espargaro 9, Yoni Hernandez 10, Aleix Espargaro with Suzuki 11, Petrucci 12, Scott Redding 13, Maverick Vinales 14th, and 15th place, the final point scorer, Hector Barbera. This is about one man. Everything else has been about Ducati, it's been about Marc Marquez, it's gone. The headlines will be Valentino Rossi.
Vintage Valentino Rossi there. What a performance from the 36-year-old. Incredible stuff. That medium hard front tyre, crucial in the outcome of that race, definitely, Nick.
Take a breath. 20th season of Grand Prix racing. His 313th Grand Prix appearance. No pipe and slippers for Valentino Rossi. That was as tough a win as you would see. Well done, Ducati. Well done, Andrea Dovizioso. I thought he was going to win it. Rossi had a different idea.
Marc Marquez kicks off the defence of his world championship with fifth. That was a rousing fight back from the Spaniard, of course. We saw him run off at the very first corner of the race, almost run into the back of that man right behind him now on the slowing down lap, Bradley Smith. Jorge Lorenzo, he'll be bitterly disappointed. He made the running for much of the race, but missed out on the podium. In all the jubilant scenes for Valentino Rossi, Andrea Iannone, he took his first Premier Class rostrum. A great ride from Maniac Joe, great Willie from the number 29, but it's all about
it is
one man.
But what a debut for the GP15 at Ducati. Second and third, absolutely brilliant. But
Andrea
as he often does, he will steal the headlines, won't he, completely.
Dovizioso could not have done anything more in that race. He tried to lead it, he put pressure on Lorenzo, he put pressure on Rossi, but you have to say, Valentino Rossi, when the pressure was on, he delivered a masterful final lap. There he is, punching the air in delight, and quite rightly so. As we said, 313.
Terrific. Yamaha and Ducati exchanging pleasantries before they come in.
And Yamaha, Nick, all weekend had looked dead and buried, haven't they?
Absolutely out of it. Here he comes, 36 years old, his 313th Grand Prix appearance. Ducati, second and third, but on the top step of the podium. Listen to the reception. The doctor is getting here in Qatar.
What a way for Yamaha to kick off its 60th anniversary celebrations. Could not have made a better start. Valentino Rossi revving that Weiser M1 motor as he comes in to Parc Fermé. He still celebrates every victory like it was the first one, and it was a classic Rossi performance, fighting his way through from way down the field. He was 10th on the first lap, but there he is, Valentino Rossi, 36 years of age, and still able to win.
What a face, Marc
Marquez. Not happy at all.
No, not happy at all.
When Marc Marquez watches this race back on video, he would have loved to have been in that fight for the victory. Andrea Dovizioso, as we say, he did his absolute best to deny Rossi. A fantastic day before the new GP15. That's going to be a force to be reckoned with,
yeah,
as we move into the season. Two Ducatis on the podium with Valentino Rossi. So a
lasted great
start.
The pace, didn't it? Both of them lasted the pace well. It was only the brilliance of probably the greatest motorcycle racer we've ever seen that actually prevented them having a debut victory. Well, we've both watched many, many victories of Valentino Rossi. I don't think I've seen many better than that. Have you?
108 career victories before tonight, Nick, and I tend to agree. His 109th is right up there with the very, very best. It was breathtaking action from the two Italians. An all-Italian podium, of course, Rossi, Dovizioso and Iannone. Lorenzo missing out after a valiant fight. He did his best to stay in there for as long as possible. Andrea Dovizioso takes a deep intake of breath, and quite rightly, because he put up a tremendous fight. Lynn Jarvis and all the Yamaha management congratulating Valentino Rossi. He rolled back the years once again, didn't he? Victorious last year in Misano and Phillip Island. We keep wondering every year, can he come back to deliver another championship challenge? Well, there's your answer.
Write him off at your peril. That's what you do. And what a start to the season. And where will it go from there? Well, you know Marc Márquez is going to fight back. Ducati have proved they're right in there. But Rossi has done it again.
Well, Andrea, that was some amazing race there. And at the end, you really had to push, but a podium on your first Ducati ride.
Yes, this is my first podium in MotoGP. It's incredible. I'm really emotional. But I want thanks a lot the Ducati guys, because this winter, the work is incredible and the bike improved a lot. I'm really, really happy.
Cool. Thank you very much, Andrea.
He's happy, he's tired. And he's taken his first ever podium in MotoGP. Doesn't get a lot better than that. I think he deserves a drink. I think they're saying, can you come and do the interview? He says, hang on a minute, I've got to take my gum shield out. So here is Andrea Dovizioso. I think he's still celebrating with the Ducati team. I don't think you can blame him. He's coming, Dylan. Here he comes. So Andrea Dovizioso, GP15 from pole, second place for the Italian and the Italian
Although
factory.
First you had to fight with Jorge Lorenzo, then you had Valentino Rossi. I think one of the best races ever. You must be tired.
Yes, he's really happy to come back and fight for the victory. And in the last few laps, I pushed really hard, over 100% in the last lap. I made a really good lap time, but I didn't have any more grip on the edge. And it was impossible to try to attack Valentino. He was really strong in the braking, but in the first part of the acceleration, he was better. And anyway, second position, the first race is really good. Thank you to the team, really.
Thank you very much, Dobby.
Yeah, pretty honest assessment. And it's the first race for the bike. Where is that going to end up? Valentino Rossi, we can't believe it. 313th Grand Prix appearance, and he wins here in Qatar.
Well, Valentino, you won the first race of 2015, a difficult start, but then I think one of the best ever fights in your career.
Yeah, you know, I said this a lot of times, but for me, this is one of the best, because after the bad start, I recovered a lot. We did a very great job during the practice, and my bike was fantastic. And step by step, I arrived there. I try to don't give up. The bike move everywhere, but after with the two Ducatis and with the Jorge was difficult, but in some places I was very strong, very good in the line, and I'm so happy for me, for my team, for Yamaha, for all the guys that are with me. Ciao.
Thanks, Valentino.
I suppose you're 36-year-old. You deserve to be a bit puffed after a race like that, don't you, Matt?
A breathless and faultless performance from the 9-times world champion. He loved that one, didn't he? As he said, one of the best of his career, and who can argue with that? It was a terrific performance. Celebrating with some of his mechanics who have been through the journey right from when he first joined the Premier Class back in 2000. There's been some magic moments in those 15 years, but not many that will beat this one tonight in Qatar. Majestic performance by the 9-times world champion. 17 more of those, please, gentlemen.
Final results. Valentino Rossi wins his 109th Grand Prix. What a victory from Rossi, 36 years old. What a debut by the GP15 Ducati. Dovizioso second, Iannone third. Jorge Lorenzo in fourth place. Marc Márquez, after being very last after the first corner, fifth. Pedrosa sixth. In seventh place, Cal Crutchlow. Eighth, Bradley Smith. Ninth, Paul Espargaro. And tenth, Jonny Hernández. The little bit further down, Aleix Espargaró on the Suzuki debut, 11th. 12th, Danilo Petrucci. Scott Redding, 13th. Maverick Viñales, 14th. And Hector Barbera, 15th place.
And Carol Abraham and Jack Miller, they both crashed out on the final lap, Nick. So the Czech rider and the Australian rookie not finishing what was an absolute classic 22-lap race. We saw a great battle last year between Rossi and Marquez. This year, it was between Rossi and Dovizioso, the two Italians.
Wow, there he is. He leads the world championship. It's the first time since Germany 2013 that Marc Marquez hasn't led the MotoGP World Championship. Don't worry, he'll be right in there, right in their face when we get to Austin in 2 weeks' time. So I think he's won there the last 2 years, hasn't he?
I think I'm right in saying as well, Nick, that's the first time that Valentino Rossi would have led the World Championship since he won this race here 5 years ago, back in 2010.
Wow.
So he gets better with age. He's like a good old bottle of wine, is he, Valentino?
Yeah. Somebody uncorked the wine today, though, didn't he? Yeah, interesting to say. He said, I talk about my best ever race. As a spectator, I don't think I've nearly seen him ride any better than that ever. I thought that was a phenomenal performance.
Well, we say every year that we see Valentino Rossi that he is riding in the form of his life. Well, he's performed again tonight. Silvano Galbisera is that crew chief, of course, who took over the difficult job of replacing Gerry Burgess at the beginning of last season. Valentino said it was a difficult decision, one of the toughest of his career, but he felt like he needed new motivation, and boy, did it work. Two wins last year, and he's kicked off 2015 with a phenomenal victory, an all-Italian podium to kick off 2015. Andrea Iannone, Andrea Dovizioso, and Valentino Rossi.
So here are the two Ducati riders. It's of course the new crew chief also there. People keep saying, what is going to happen to MotoGP when Valentino Rossi disappears? He's got absolutely no intention of disappearing.
He's going nowhere. He signed a new two-year contract last year. Andrea Iannone soaking up the moment. He won't forget this, his first MotoGP podium. But listen to the roar for Valentino Rossi, still the most popular rider in the championship, no doubt about that. Rossi jumps on the top step of the podium for the 83rd time in his MotoGP career.
What a start, and what a great achievement for the crew chief who's been with him now just for 1 year.
Well, Galbisera said he felt under pressure last year, but when Valentino said we can win a 10th world title, the pressure just got ramped up. And the pressure was on, you have to say, 8th on the grid they started. Nobody really gave Yamaha a sniff the race. It was all about Ducati and Honda. Well, Ducati were there, but Valentino Rossi denied them a famous victory. The long wait goes on for Ducati, but to Andrea Iannone, that'll take pride of place when he gets home in Italy, his first podium. Gigi Dallini, quite rightly, big round of applause for Iannone and Andrea Dovizioso too.
Here is Andrea Dovizioso, second place for the Italian. He started the race from pole position. The GP15 Ducati, third and second. But even the might of Ducati could not defeat Valentino Rossi this time around. There's some big, big battles that lie ahead. You've got to throw Marc Marquez into that occasion, but listen to this. He's 36 years old. He's starting his 20th season of Grand Prix racing. This was his 313th Grand Prix. Valentino Rossi wins here in Qatar.
Listen to...
Italy 1, Italy 2, Italy 3. Valentino Rossi 1, Dovizioso 2, Iannone 3. What an evening here. We have seen three incredible races, three so different races. What a start to 2015. Get buying those tickets for Austin, Texas in 2 weeks' time, and then of course Rio Turves Honda in Argentina in 3 weeks' time. Rossi is on the charge. Ducati are after him. Mark has had a bad night, but he will be back big time. He has won for the last two times at Austin, which is the next round of the championship. Listen to the crowd. What a night we've had here in Qatar. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as us.